My name is Nick Leister, and I'm a member of the SolidWorks training team. In this multi-video series, I will show you how to start with SolidWorks as a model a pair of needle-nose pliers. In this video, the third in the series, I'll demonstrate the tools and techniques for removing material using the Cut Extrude feature. Let's get started. I'll start this first extruded cut with a sketch on the front face of the model, which will form the hole for the pin. I'll use the circle command and place my first selection at the origin to center it. The diameter of the pin is 3/8 of an inch, so I'll use the smart dimension command to ensure the hole is the same size. Now, I'll use this sketch for the cut extrude, which I'll access through the Features tab of the Command Manager. The Cut Extrude feature operates similarly to the Extruded Boss Base command, but removes material instead of adding material. The Cut Extrude extends the part's thickness 1/2 inch, so these settings will deliver the desired outcome. However, I'll use the drop-down and select Through All, ensuring the cut extends through the currently modeled geometry, regardless of thickness. I'll click OK. The hole looks good. Now, I'll use a previously defined sketch with a cut extrude to form the cutout that will form the faces that will join the pliers together. I'll expand the first boss extrude feature from the feature manager tree to do this. Here, we see the sketch I used to define this feature. I'll select the sketch and click Show, the eye icon, to overlay the sketch on top of the geometry. Now, I'll click Cut Extrude and select the circular sketch profile. The preview indicates that the cut will remove half the part's thickness with the Through All option selected, which occurs because the sketch is in the part's center. I'll click Reverse Direction to toggle the side from which I'll remove material. I'll click OK. The cut looks good. I'll toggle off the sketch's visibility by selecting it and clicking Hide. Now, I'll create the third cut extrude, which will narrow the head of the pliers. I'll form this cut with an open sketch profile that will start from the inside face of the plier's head. I'll select the face and click Sketch from the pop-up. I'll access the Line command and pick up on the top edge to start the line, carefully avoiding the edge's midpoint inference. I'll terminate the line at the vertex. I'll use the Smart Dimension command to create a horizontal dimension between the origin and the top of the line. The Smart Dimension command's flexibility enables me to create linear, vertical, and horizontal dimensions. Therefore, before I click, I'll move my cursor so the preview shows the intended dimension. I'll specify 1/8 of an inch for the dimension, which constrains the sketch. This open sketch is all I need to create the cut I intend to make, so I'll exit out of the sketch environment. Now, I'll click Extruded Cut. The preview displays three arrows. The arrow perpendicular to the profile indicates what material the feature will cut away. Activating Flip Side to Cut toggles the arrow's direction. I'll deactivate Flip Side to Cut to remove the sliver geometry and click OK. In the following video, I'll show you how to use the mirror feature to replicate this cut on the other side of the part. I'll also show you how to use the Fillet command to round off this model's sharp corners. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, watch the following video in this series and visit the site below to access a complete SolidWorks CAD Fundamentals playlist.